the police threatened to kill a rapper for sitting in his car. Let me take you to the audio. Here it is.
Around. You can take off in this car, I'm gonna shoot you. I'm gonna make it super easy on you. You put this car in drive, you're getting one right to the chest. So I don't care what you got, I don't care on you, but guess what, bro? Now you gotta deal with it. But if you're gonna take one to the chest.
So you're gonna shoot me right
absolutely.
Now?
Absolutely. Absolutely. If you don't listen, you're done. You understand?
You're gonna shoot me for sitting in the car?
You gonna comply or no?
Comply what?
I'm sitting in your hands from right there, you're in trouble.
So you're gonna shoot me? I'm sitting in the damn car, bro. I'm sitting in the damn car.
Move your hands from right there and you're done.
So I'm under arrest or what, bro? You got guns on me like I'm a
You are most definitely 1,050% detained. If you do anything other than what you're doing right now, then you're going to have some major.
It's a damn shame. Put up the picture for a mask. Let me explain something. This officer said what was in his mind. Most officers are saying the same thing, but not out loud. They approach a vehicle with a human being that happens to be in black skin. They approach this vehicle with the notion that if this person just gives them a reason, if this person moves a certain way, they're ready to do what? To kill them. That was the energy the officer brought. So two deputies, and this was in LA, two deputies approached rapper Feezy Lebron in Crenshaw earlier this week. I'm glad he posted the audio of this encounter because it is important to understand the mindset of individuals like this cop. You can't reform that. There's no sensitivity training for him. Nah. There's no suspension with or without pay. He could come back later. This individual is rotten to the core, just like the majority of police right now in most jurisdictions across this country, rotten to the damn core. So rotten, they can't even smell their own funk anymore. That's how rotten they are. They think they're right. They're not. So let's do this. Put up the picture of the cop. The two sheriff's deputies who have been identified as Jacob Ruiz and Justin Sabatine approached the rapper who had been sitting in a parking lot with the engine off. Now remember, this is a human being. This is a person. If they have a reason to engage, engage them with respect. There are conflicting facts on where he was parked. One report said his friend's private lot, another said a strip mall lot. Per the account of the rapper, the officers were immediately apprehensive and assumed the artist was simply going to drive off without any indication that would ever happen. While the clip ends during what seemed to be the most heated part of the audio, things only escalated off camera when the two deputies in question searched through LeBron's vehicle. It was clear to him at this point that there must have been a motive behind the volatile incident, particularly since LeBron knew he had not done anything wrong. I have my license, I have my registration, I have my insurance, I have everything I need to have. I wasn't sitting there smoking marijuana. I didn't have any of that going on, he explained in a separate post on Instagram. Isn't this really sad that we have to prove we have a right to simply be? The man was just being, he was just there. Now he has to provide all of this context and documentation as to why he could be there without a problem. You don't have to do that, or at least you should not have to do that. You actually have a constitutional right of mobility, interstate travel, that's codified in the Constitution. You can go where you choose to go. You have the freedom of assembly, codified in the Constitution. These rights are given to you according to the doctrine of this nation. But as I say, culture eats policy alive every day. So while there's a written policy about the rights this man should have, there's a culture that's antithetical to that written policy, and you just saw it. There's more. I'm hearing his voice, he says. I'm hearing his voice. And it's like, he's got so much rage, almost like roid rage. So I just want to not escalate it. But at the same time, I do want to understand why this is happening. As you can see in the video though, he really couldn't give me an answer about the justification for the stop. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department has yet to respond to the incident. In the meantime, fans have been flooding Twitter, calling for the officers to be fired or disciplined. We join his fans in that same sentiment. Conscious thoughts here.
Man, really, for the black folks watching this, when it comes to me and how I do it, this is the reason why I don't like to play those left versus right games a lot, especially when we start talking about how black people are positioned in particular states. This man got his rights violated in the beautiful state, the blue state of California, you know, a state that is ran by Democrats and ran by liberals. But we see it's something unique about black skin, that regardless how much the left versus the right beef, when it comes to material reality, there are some things that you feel me can be agreed on, I feel like. You know, the second thing is going back to that patriotism idea. Young Lee was sold patriotism by the idea that red coats were doing harsh and unusual punishment to literal, you feel me, colonizers, the colonists, I don't call them colonizers, to the colonists, you know what I'm saying, and making it where we should always be able to be happy about the rights that we have. The last thing I'll say is that what happened to that man in California, our government justifies invading multiple national corporations and national companies, because of fascism, because of the loss of rights. And this is very important to point out. Our tax dollars goes to invade other countries to make sure their citizens isn't done the way black folks is done in America.
And think about this, we are forced to finance our own oppression because these police departments are financed by black dollars as well.
As well.
And when they start to police black bodies in a way that is obviously oppressive, aggressive, and inappropriate, we are forced to pay for our own oppression.